Madonna.
Thank you very much, Comrade Patrick. Before I call on our next speaker from Zimbabwe, I also want to emphasize what the comrade was saying. Those of us who were involved in the struggle in the 80s were inspired by Comrade Mugabe. You know, when people struggled here in the 60s and 70s, it was one day there'd be freedom, but we had never seen this freedom. But in 1980, when we saw Robert Mugabe taking over power and defeating Ian Smith, we knew that it was possible. That is why the decade of the 80s was the decade that finally crushed the apartheid racist regime, because we could see that it could be done. So we want to thank you, comrades of ZANU-PF, and comrades like Robert Mugabe and Joshua Nkomo are what inspired the struggle in this country. Amanda! My next speaker is going to be another former commissar in the ZANU-PF Central Committee, and another former minister, our comrade Xavier Kasukwere, that was mentioned here earlier. Comrade Xavier.
Amanda! Amanda! Viva EFF, viva! Forward, Comrade Julius Malema, forward! Forward, the leadership of the EFF, forward! Abash imperialism! Thank you very much, comrades. The CIC and president of the EFF, Comrade Julius Malema, Comrade Floyd Shiwambu, the Vice President, our National Chairman, Advocate Dalim Pofu, the leadership of the EFF here present. My dear brother has just spoken to us, Honorable Patrick Shuau. I'm also accompanied by our team. There's Comrade Shadrick Mashaya Mombe, who was a Member of Parliament. We have with us Comrade Mashange, Honorable Mashange, was a Member of Parliament, and indeed we have our sister who blessed this occasion. Thank you very much, my dear sister. Indeed, today is not an easy day for many of us. But let me take this opportunity to thank, first and foremost, Comrade Julius Malema and this important family of the EFF. When I chatted a few days ago with Comrade Malema, he said to me, "Comrade Tyson, we are having the memorial service of the late President Arajim Mugabe. I was in Singapore. And he said, you must be here. We are here where it matters most. This kind of gathering is happening in Soweto, where the people genuinely loved President Arajim Mugabe. There is no such gathering center. There is no such gathering in the affluent suburbs of South Africa and anywhere else in Africa. Because what is truthful resonates with us who are here today. Resonates with the EFF. Resonates with the revolutionaries who want a different Africa. The young men and women in our country, in our region, in Africa, who want a new future for themselves. They want to be part and parcel of the economy. The challenge we have, Comrade Malema, is what I call political assimilation. When the political leaders are chosen from amongst us, the moment they come into contact with the WMCs, they forget about the poor people. They have a different story. It's all about what kind of projection, how am I viewed by Western imperial capital. If you talk to anybody who gets into power. The moment they start buying cufflinks, nice bow ties, nice suits, Gucci perfumes, they forget about the people of the EFF who are here in Soweto. Mugabe, President Mugabe, was chosen by the poor people in our country to be president. Hence, what he stood for made those with the riches angry with him. The moment you see yourself becoming acceptable to Western capital, just stand back and say, hey, comrade, where am I selling out now? What is the problem? What have I done? African leaders to lead us. The moment he gets into the office, he starts thinking about, how will I be viewed in London? What is the capitals of cash in New York say? Washington. But the people who chose you in Soweto, they are not in Washington. Let's first of all answer to the aspiration of the people in Soweto, not in Washington. I hope, Comrade Malema, the lessons that we have gone through in our country, and I thank you for remembering this gallant son of Africa. He belonged. He was the son of the soil. He was not scared. When it came to taking our land, this Madara was not scared. Bob was not scared. Bob was not scared. Bob was not scared. He said, Rivians, while we went to war, was the land. And he simply said, take the land. And he was a very stubborn old man. He would be moving around. Say, Madara, are you not scared? The whites are angry. Says, angry about what? Here I was born, here I shall die, and here I will be buried. Let the land come back to be master. If President Mugabe was a coward, we'd still be negotiating about how the terms in which we'll get the land, we'll be having discussions and meetings about the way suffering to our country. But comrades, never you sacrifice the principle on the altar of expediency. It is the foundation that is laid for us, is laid for Africa, where we call upon leadership like Comrade Malema. Let's build the economic independence of our people from what these old men have done. Those old men who were not scared to go in prison. For 11 years he was there. Yeah. He lost his job out in prison, never gave up. He was harassed, he left the country, went to live in Mozambique, he never gave up. He led ZANU forces from Mozambique, he never gave up. He was insulted. He had degrees taken away from him, which had been given by the British. He said, for as long as I'm doing the right thing for my people, I will not turn back. I'll give my people land, doesn't matter. Comrade Malema, leadership does not require cowards. If you are a coward, get out of the kitchen. If you are a coward, get out of the kitchen. You spoil our food in the kitchen. Amadou Dasili is what we require in the kitchen. Men who steal, women who steal, who will say, this is where we want to go. Africa, if we're going to have our employment controlling, we don't want people who are scared. We have in our country now, they are busy replacing empowerment laws to make who happy. And not wanting all foreigners to come and invest in our country. Did we ever ask for a foreign leader to come back and take over from Nangabo? If you want us also to look, no, we need somebody who can do better, let's say we hire George Bush, or let's hire Trump to run Zimbabwe. No, we believe in you as a black man. Believe in me as an economic man. If we have a leadership that does not believe in black people, hey, comrades, they must just go in. We are sick and tired. My wife is black. My daughter is black. I am black. My father is black. Why should I compromise? Why do you think we need to waste my time? When I die, I get buried by the people who are also black. It's the time, Comrade Malema, we turn around and say, they own the country. Let's empower them. The minerals of South Africa. We can't continue talking about it. I'm a quotas, you know, we need to arrange quotas. No, many comrades. These are ours. God brought me as a black man to Africa. That's why I'm black. You have your own territory. I have not come to yours to eat from you. You want to come and eat from me and say, no, man, just relax. Don't disturb me right here. He's a very nice man. I also want to eat. Don't disturb me when I want to eat. So young people here, members of the EFF, the job to liberate Africa begins now. We do it because it is right for us to do it. I'm saying this, I know I'm in big trouble. But trouble is not what I'm looking for. I'm not just now going around looking for trouble. Because if you become too nice, you have a problem. I'm looking for trouble. My brother will tell you when I was a youngster, I did some of the things that nobody can ever do. I took a little stick. There was a mango tree in our homestead. And there were these bees, a huge beehive. I said, hey, this thing is stopping us from eating these mangoes. I attacked that beehive. Next thing, I was in the hospital. But I survived. If I could survive those bees, let's fight again. We will survive another fight. So, Comrade Julius, I want to thank you very much, my dear brother. If you ask me about the story of the EFF and this formation, I know it from A to Z. I was there with this young comrade. This man is a strong man.
Tata, tutu, tata.